All right, questions from the homework? Harvey?
If you did the whole thing, like, do we have like,
Any questions that, like, you want me to work through them? Carter?
No.
Can you go to number two?
Number two?
Yeah. So I got nine.
Oh, yeah, I did two.
How'd you get nine? You have to have a B in there.
I got nine minus one B. I got nine.
I got nine B.
Are we all done talking about what each of us got? Just waiting. Mostly for Aubrey. Okay. The thing that you need to remember here is this is a, you know, this is letter B in case it didn't look quite like a B. It looks pretty good like a B. For example, a common mistake here, B minus three. Can we do anything with B minus three?
No.
Why not?
Because three doesn't have a B next to it.
Okay.
The same.
Three doesn't have a B next to it. Okay, that's kind of, you know, mysterious still.
The negative always goes with the three because you're subtracting three.
Okay, but what we're trying to just explain here is why, like, we can't combine these. So people want to do this, negative 2b or something like that. Usually that's the mistake that I see. Alan?
You can't put apple and oranges together.
Okay, got an apples and oranges situation. This is like apples, this is like oranges, except for it's not apples.
It's bananas.
We're not looking for a word that starts with B. We're just saying this is
different
from this. What is this?
It's a number. It's an unknown number.
Okay, it's an unknown number. We'll call it B.
It's
right?
A variable.
What is this? This is free of what?
Negative 3 ones.
I want you to hear it's 3 ones. Okay, and we're subtracting those 3 ones. So it looks something like this. 1b minus a 1 minus another 1 minus another 1. Can I take this 1 away from this b? No, b is a number that I don't know. Until I know it, I don't know what 1 less than that number is. So until that time, all I can say is that number minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1. Or b minus 3. They don't go together. They're not the same thing. We've got an apples and oranges situation here. So okay, but we do have a B here, and we're going to take a B away and take another B away. That's what minus 2B means. Okay, so if I take this B away from this B, what do I have so far?
1B.
B minus
one,
a B.
Minus
1B. Negative 1B.
Just a B minus this 1B. Where are we?
Negative 1B.
If I just take this 1B here and subtract a single B.
Negative 1B.
If I take this B and I subtract just
it's
one
zero.
B. Yes, zero. And then if I subtract another B.
Negative 1B.
Gotta listen to the thing I'm asking. I asked it at least 5 times. Alright. Now we have negative 1. We're subtracting 1. Then we're adding 1. We're adding 6 ones. So minus 3 ones plus 6 ones.
Three.
Yeah, this one cancels with that. -1 + 1 = 0. -1 + 1 = 0. -1 + 1 = 0. And we have 3. Or negative, the number -3 + 6 = +3. You don't have to write out all those ones and these, but from looking at your homework from last time, I've seen like are really struggling with. We were, at least at the beginning of last class, really struggling with combining things that should not be combined. All right? And I don't want to just say, oh, because it doesn't have a B, because that's not a very good explanation. It's not a very in-depth explanation. It's because they're just literally different things. I don't put apples and oranges together. I don't put B's and 1's together. Yes?
Okay. I have a question. Could you do 3 + -B? That still be the same?
Mm-hmm. Okay. 3 + -B. -B, all the same.
Okay.
Because no matter what that number is, if I plug a number in for B, all of these things would give me the same thing.
Okay.
Right?
Maybe we should make B the number of how many letters are in the banana.
We'll never know what B is. It's impossible to know. We could just throw numbers in there. We'll never be wrong, but we'll never be right. We'll just be throwing numbers in there for B.
So no matter what, nothing is right.
this situation, it's impossible to know what B is. Just because I said subtract a number from 3 doesn't tell me anything about what B actually is. I'll never be able to say B is a number for sure. In this situation. In an equation, it could. Alright, so that was number 2. Any others? Jackson? 15. 10x plus 36 is 38x plus 47. As JC reminded us earlier, this negative number, right, this negative belongs with the 38x. It's negative 38 times x. Maybe to help you see that, you could put plus negative, wherever you see a minus, you put plus negative, so you remember that this negative sign remains with this term. You can't just take that negative sign and just throw it on something else or make it disappear and turn into a positive for no reason whatsoever. It is part of the original problem there, and it cannot be switched around. About 10x plus 36, is that 46x?
No.
Why not, Kaden?
Because they're not the same thing.
Good. Not just because that has an x and that doesn't have an x, it doesn't really address what we're talking about here. They're not the same thing. Here we have 10x's, here we have 36 what's?
Ones.
Numbers.
Ones. Ones. 36 ones, 10x's, right? X plus 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 x 10 times, 1 plus itself 36 times. Okay. Just completely different things. So no, not 46x. But do I have some other x's that I can put
yes.
together with those x's and see what the total number of x's is?
Yeah.
10x minus 38x is gonna give me
28.
Good. Keep track of those positives and negatives. If that number should be negative, make sure you're indicating that. Here we have 36, that's 36 ones, and here we have negative 47 ones. 47 negative 1, now we're going to look at it. So 36 minus 47 is going to put us at what?
Negative 11.
36 minus 47, negative 1. So negative 28x minus 11. Jackson, does that help you? Good. Yeah, you're gonna show me how knowledgeable you are at this. So you wanna make sure you get questions out of the way, Tiana.
I need help with number 11.
Okay.
I'm not sure. And 45, but I couldn't figure out
if
to add it or not.
Well, what we have here is a negative 1 plus 46. So if we think about where we start and where we're going to end, where is negative 1 on this number line?
To the left of 0.
To the left of 0. And then we're going to add 46. On the number line, what does that look like to add 46?
To the right of the 0.
Go to the right 46. Okay, so if I go to the right 46, where am I?
45,
right? I started out back 1, so if I move forward 46, I'm at a positive 45.
Okay,
so
it would be 35 plus.
Plus, yeah.
Okay. Because I couldn't figure out if I was supposed to add or subtract it, so I guess.
Glad we straightened that out. JC?
3.
That's 7x minus 1x, there's not 1 written there, but whenever you see that, you can imply that there's a 1x, right? And so if I have 7x's, so just take a moment, that should be 7 minus an x. So how many x's do we have?
6.
All right, these are going to be 0. So we have 6x left, 6 times x. Kaden?
6.
Negative 9r plus 10r.
I got 1r.
All right.
but on your thing it's an R.
It's the same thing.
One R, R, it's the same thing. It's like, I don't know, having an apple.
That is an apple. It does look like an apple.
So if I say, hey, apple, I don't have to put one next to it, right?
Nope, it's just an apple.
You know what I mean?
It's like, it's so we're, wait, this is confusing me now. Because then it makes me think of, hey, you know those little, my sister has these little flashcards.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, animals on them.
Uh-huh.
And they don't have the numbers. But on the back, it says in words what the number is.
Uh-huh.
And so it makes me think, well, what if we've got five apples and there's no number next to it?
Yeah.
Just count the apples. It would still be five apples. We just wouldn't know how many apples. You know, we'd have to actually count them.
Yeah. But in algebra, we do put a number next to it, and we mean five times one apple, which would mean five apples.
So if that was 2R, you couldn't put R?
No, because then it's 2 times R.
Yeah, so you
could. Because 2R, well, 6X means 6 times the number X.
Which makes 6
so
of the X.
Multiply by X.
Yeah, so you couldn't just put an X
over here.
Here?
Here. Yeah, you have to put 6, because I have.
Yeah.
X plus X plus X plus X, that's 6 times X. You're getting too caught up in, can I do this, can I do that? Let's think about what it's saying. 7X, 7 times X, multiplication of a number times another number, right? So I have 7 X's added together, right? I had 7 there, and then I took one away, right? So we wind up with 6 X's added up. The short way of writing x plus x plus x plus x 6 times is 6 times x, right? Here, when we take negative 9 r's and add 10 r's to them and we have 1 r left, okay, so when I have 1 r left, I can just write r. That means whatever number r I choose for R to be, it just goes there. If I write 1 times that number, it's the same, right? Whether I just say R and I just put that number in there, I put that number in there, multiply by 1, it's all the same. These are the same as each other, okay? 6X is meaning 6 groups of X, 6 times X, X plus itself 6 times.
Was that the same as X?
This?
Yeah.
No. Just 1X is the same as X. If I just write X, how in the world would I know that there's 6 of these being added together, right? There's no way to know. So, but the variable you're using, X, I guess you could make up a new variable and say Y, right? And add up 6 X's to get Y, so I'm gonna put that number, and Y is X added to itself 6 times. I'm adding up 6 X's, I have 6 X's. If I only have 1 R, I can write 1 times R, or I can write R. That's all the same. Of course, like, for example, 6 R is not the same as just writing R. Other questions? Tiana?
4.
If it's
just supposed to be 3p. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be negative 3p.
It is negative
3p. Okay, that's all I needed to
clarify.
Yeah, because there's the 7p's, and then you gotta add 10p's, or take away 10p's. But then, since we only have 7p's, you gotta, you know, it's like little p's. I'm thinking of dinner right now.
Okay. So you have 7p's, and if I subtract 10 of them, well, I subtracted 7.
Yeah, but then
right? So how do I show I'm going to subtract 3 more p's?
Yeah,
right?
you just have imaginary p's.
And then negative, not imaginary, imaginary is something else. There are imaginary numbers.
I'm thinking of dinner.
But so negative is not imaginary.
There were 7 p's and you wanted to take 10 away from your relative.
Any other questions?
Nope.
Okay, put everything away. All right, so we have 5x plus 2 minus 3x. Now, 5x plus 2 is not 7x. It is not 7x. Okay. Lane?
I did 5x minus 3x. Is that right?
talking about how it's not 7x right now. Why is it not 7x? Okay, apples and oranges is a good analogy. We have five apples and two oranges. They're just completely different things, right? Now we don't actually have apples and oranges. What we actually have, x's and ones. We have five x's. Five x's. Add up five x's. Well, that could take a long time to write out. So the short way of saying that is five times x. Just like 3 plus 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 3. How could we write that a little bit of a shorter way?
3 times 8. 3 times 8. 3 times 8.
Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 8 threes. 8 groups of 3. So multiply 8 by 3. We learned early on when we start learning about numbers as young children. We learn about addition, and then when we add up the same number a bunch of times, that's where we come up with multiplication.
Yeah, that's
not. So add up a bunch of threes. You can just multiply however many threes there are by 3. 8 times 3. And in the same way, 5x means 5x's added together. And if we add 2, we're adding 1, and we're adding 1 again. And we might as well finish this out. Minus x, minus x, minus x. Some of these things can be combined together, but some of them can't. These are just not the same. So we have five x's, and we have three negative x's. So what's this x plus this negative x? X plus this negative x.
4, 0. 0.
And this, so that, and that go to 0. And this x plus this negative x? Also 0, this plus this negative x will be 0, and we're left with what?
You're left with positive 2x.
Positive 2x, very good.
Then you just drop down the other x, and then you get positive 2 plus positive 2x.
What other x?
What? I said you get positive 2 plus positive 2x.
Okay, two, or 2x plus 2, 2 plus 2x, they're the same? So either way. When we add two numbers, it doesn't matter if I do 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2, we have the exact same result.
Mm-hmm.
So we can switch that order up as well. All right. Here, again, 6 minus 4x. I cannot take 6 and subtract 4x and then call it, sounds like 2x or anything. I cannot combine a 6 and a negative 4x into one thing. I can just leave it like that. But 6 ones plus 7 more ones. Well, I can put those together. There's no reason to take 6 and subtract this and add 7 later on. Why don't we just say it's the same as having 13? We have 13 ones. In this whole process, we're going to add 13 at some point. And we have negative 4x plus 8x, or 4 negative x's and 8 positive x's. Negative x's cancel with positive x's. We're left with positive 4x. You can put ones together with ones, x's together with x's, and then you stop, right? You don't try to put together x's with non-x's. You push this to another level. How about x, let's see, 3x plus 4y? Just something I'm making up on the fly here. What would 3x plus 4y be?
3x plus 4y, because they're different variables, so.
They're different things. There's 3x's. It's 4y's. If I try to add these 3x's to these 4y's,
you get variables. You just get adding variables.
You don't get 7 things.
You just get numbers.
So
you don't get 7 numbers.
So we have 3x's, 4y's, 3 apples, 4 oranges.
You
don't
still
try to add those together to get 7. Any questions about that? Right. Do you think I could explain any more or say any more clearly that x's and 1's can't be added together?
Mm-hmm.
I know some of you got it to the point where you're annoyed that I'm even saying this again.
Yeah.
But also some people don't got it to the point they really need some help. So that puts us in a difficult position. So if you're still having trouble understanding why 13 plus 4x is not 17x, okay, then you know, continue to ask questions or come to me outside of class and try and help you. Or give you lots of practice sheets and you can practice that over and over, okay? Go over number two again? Sure. Let's just get rid of all of that. Start over. Okay. So here we have 8 times x, which is just 8 x's. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And here we have negative 4 x's, and I can rewrite this as 6 plus 7 plus 8x minus 4x because it's they call the commutative property of addition that says I can rearrange addition of numbers in any order that I want. So I can add the 6 plus the 7, the 8x minus the 4x. And I can see this 8x, which is what I've represented here with 8 x's being added together, minus 4x, well that's minus an x, minus a second x, minus a third x, minus a fourth x. And if I combine this positive and negative x together, if I'm adding them, which I am, they cancel each other out. And this x minus x cancels each other out. X minus x cancels each other out. X minus x cancels each other out. We have 4 x's. X plus x plus x plus x. I could write that. I could write 13 plus x plus x plus x plus x. And that would be correct. But this is a long way of saying what? This is a long way of saying 13x?
13
plus 4 times x. That's why we write 4x. It means 4 times x. It's faster than writing x plus x plus x plus x. And it saves us a lot of time when it's like 13x or 25x or something like that. And then when I get to here, 13 plus 4x, I don't try to put those together because I remember that 13 and, well, 13 is a number of 1s that are being added together. 4x is a number of x's being added together. It's like apples and oranges. Can't have them together. Kaden?
So like all the like numbers that like 6 minus 4x, so minus goes with the 4x and the plus goes with the 7, they always stick together.
Like the signs we're talking about?
Yeah.
They do. If this negative is in front of the 4x, then it's always with the 4x. Like if we had, let's just like use some numbers. 5 minus 7 plus 6. 9 is 10.
So it would, plus and 6 would always stay together.
Mm-hmm.
And plus and 9
mm-hmm.
and minus and 10.
Mm-hmm. Just think about, these are like kind of directions of what to do on the number line.
Well, 5.
Okay. Start at 5. There we are. There's 0. And we'll start at 5. Now, as I jump around here, one instruction says like, go to the right 5. This says I want to go to the left 7, right? To the left 7. That moving to the left 7 needs to happen. No matter what order it happens in, it needs to happen. Going to the left 7 needs to be part of this whole process. So if I instead do 5 plus 6 plus 9, one of the things that I do needs to be going to the left 7, just like the 7 I needed to do. You do this in any order, move to the right sum, move to the left sum, move to the right sum, move to the left sum. As long as the rights go to the right amount, and the lefts go to the left, the correct amount.
So that 5 just is a 5?
Well, it could be 6 plus, so you can start at 6 and then move to the right 5. Then move to the left 10, and move to the right 9, and the left 7. If I do this in this order, go to the right 5, right 6, right 9, left 7, left 10. Or I start at 5, go left 7, right 6, right 9, left 10. Or start at 6 and go right 5 and go left 10 and go right 9 and go left 7. Doesn't matter which of these I do in the order that I've written them down, will always wind up where?
At the place at the end of the numbers.
The answer at what number would this be?
Four. No.
Four.
Five. You hit No, you end up at three. Three.
I think it's
four.
Three, yeah.
Four.
Yeah, three. No, it's three.
Well, let's see.
Four. It's three.
There's 11
oh,
plus
that
9
one.
Is the 20.
Oh.
Minus 17 would be 3.
Yeah.
So no matter which one I do, if I go to the right 5, right 6, right 9, left 7, left 10, I'll wind up at 3. If I go to the right 5, left 7, right 6, right 9, left 10, I'll wind up at 3. Right 6, right 5, left 10, right 9, left 7, I wind up at 3. Okay. So you can see with numbers how this go to the left 7, you have to go to the left 7. You can't go to the right 7, you're supposed to go to the left 7. You can't go to the left 5, you're supposed to go to the right 5. So in that way, I'm trying to explain that yes, the signs follow the numbers around. Okay. So when we see this minus 4x, it's always a minus 4x, never a plus 4x, not minus something else that was positive to start with. Okay. Any other questions about that? Because we're going to put like just one more layer on top of this combining like terms stuff. So we have 5 parentheses minus 2. If I look at that side by side with like 5 times 7 minus 2. Now these are both numbers in here, and they were inside the parentheses. I did the parentheses first, right? So we're looking at the distributive property today. I could say 5 times 5, right? Hopefully writing this in our notes, taking diligent notes. 7 minus 2 is 5. That's inside the parentheses. I can do that. Parentheses first, order of operations. Great. All right. And then 5 times 5 is 25. But we can see that that is the same as if I were to multiply both of these by 5 and subtract. So I get 35 minus 10. And what's 35 minus 10? Exactly the same, 25. Whether I distribute that multiplication or I do the parentheses first and then multiply, I get the same thing. The reason why we're talking about that is because there is no way to take x minus 2. I can't do x minus 2. That's not negative x, it's not negative 2x, it's x minus 2. These are not the same kinds of things, so I don't try to combine them. The distributive property gives me 5x is 10. 5 times x, 5 times negative 2, and you get negative 10. You try. 3 times 2x minus 4. Distribute 3 times 2x is
3
times 2x minus 3 times 4 is 6x minus
12.
Now you can't do 3 plus 2x and get something, right? But 3 times 2x, 3 times 2x, 2x means x plus x. 3 times something means add it together 3 times, so x plus x plus x plus x plus x plus x. 3 times 2x is 6x.
Exactly. So you're saying we couldn't add the apples and oranges together?
We're not adding apples and oranges, we're multiplying 3 by 2x.
You can't combine them together.
Do the last part, the last, what, 5 problems? 22 on that worksheet, same worksheet. Make sure they're correct.